Hey everybody, I'm Shauna and I'm going to show you how to use Novelist Plus, which is a way for you to customize your own reading list. We've had access to this tool for a while, but the best part is that we now have it connected to our library catalog. So if you happen to be searching on Novelist Plus, you can immediately search to see if what you found there is actually available in the library. So how to get to this tool? You're going to go to the Madison County Public Library's homepage, and you're going to scroll beneath the scrolling announcements to this reader advisory help. Now you'll see quite a few things here now. We do have a personalized reading list. This is a form that you can complete that will be sent to the library staff, and the library staff will look at your suggestions and your likes and dislikes and put together a curated list for you. You can also do Novelist Plus, which is what we're going to talk about today. And the other thing is, if you find that there's something that you really want and it's nowhere in the Cardinal system, then you can actually complete a material purchase request to see if it's something that the library might want to purchase for its collection. It's not a guarantee of purchase, but it is a request of purchase. So we're going to look at Novelist Plus. This allows you to be in control of putting your customization together. And I'm going to show you a few tools that are really cool about Novelist Plus. So when you get to the landing page, you might, from your house, you might be prompted to access this with your library card number, because this is provided to us through NC Live. It's free to anyone who has a library card. So you might be prompted for that. You just put in all of those digits underneath the barcode in your library, from your library card number. So there are a few ways to search here. You have this recommended reading list over on the side. One of my particular favorite parts about the reading list is there are seasonal aspects. So maybe it's something that is really trending in pop culture, then they might have a reading list to go along with it. They are right now, currently, they have what is most popular that people are reading during the pandemic. They also have their own staff favorites. And then I do like this for fans of, and you can click on this and a bunch of different things from pop culture. So if you're like a really big fan of Harry Potter and you've read all the Harry Potter books 7 or 8 times, maybe you want some suggested reading that would go along with that. So fun stuff there on the suggested reading list. The other thing that you can see right here is you can choose your book based on the kind of mood you want to experience. We all know sometimes there are books that you're just not in the mood for at that point in your life. That's fine. So these have a few tabs here with different moods. So if you want something leisurely paced but nice and atmospheric, or you want something really suspenseful and compelling, or you're more dramatic and courageous, or haunting and spare, or if you're like, none of that appeals to me, then you can do this appeal mixer, which allows you to pick a lot of the adjectives and the mood that you want to experience. If you notice too, you can curate your list based on age. So you can look at adult or teen or 9-year-old to 12-year-old or even younger. Scrolling down, you'll see how you can browse by genre. And also these are grouped by age groups. And then there's always going to be a featured award winner and then a featured audiobook. Now, one of the best things about Novelist Plus is the read-alike feature. So if you have just finished an author or a book and you loved it and you are so excited because you want more like it, you can type that author's name. So here's Louise Penny, for example. I've kind of been on a Louise Penny kick lately. and I can tell it to search for this name. It'll give you a little bit of information about the author, and it also tells you what genre, all this kind of stuff. Over on the side, you will see a list of authors that are suggested that are like her. Pretty cool stuff. If you go on down, you'll start to see some of the books that she has written. And it gives you just a little snippet about the book itself. It also gives you a rating. There are connections to Goodreads reviews, if you're interested in that. And then we have other ways to search these read-alikes. So maybe I really liked this specific book by her, then I can search a title read-alike. And when I click on that, it will give me a list of other books that are a lot like that specific title by her. You can even print it out, bring it to the library, whatever. But I'm going to show you a way to skip that step in just a minute. There are your author read-alikes, so you'll get a list of the authors, and it also gives you a list of why those authors are alike. What is it about them that puts them in this group together? And then, since this book is a part of a series, let's say I've read everything in the series, but I want more like this, I can even look at this series read-alike. And it will give me a list of these series that are a lot like the ones that I just finished. So that's a game changer for a lot of you guys who really like to read books in a series. The other thing that we are very excited about here at the library is we have connected our catalog to this database. So let's say that I really want to read this book, All the Devils Are Here. Oh, I can't. It's forthcoming. Let's go down a little bit. Find something older. A Better Man. Came out August 2019. If I want to see if the library has it, I can click on this Check the Library Catalog, and it immediately routes me to the Madison County Public Library OPAC. So here it comes. It might take a little bit. That's okay. And whatever your default setting is on the live on your search, it's going to go there first. So right now it's searching all of Madison County Public Libraries. You see that right here. And it's telling me, yes, we have two copies of this book and they're both available. So I could go right ahead and place that book on hold. That sends a message to the library and we pull it off the shelf and give you a call when it's ready for pickup. But let's say that we didn't have a copy of it and we want to see if anybody in the Cardinal system does. Then all you would have to do is change your library up here from Madison County Public Library to NC Cardinal. And it's going to check all the Cardinal libraries in the consortium to see if that book exists. It'll take it a little while because there's a lot of libraries in this consortium. And when it comes up, then you will see all the libraries that do have a copy, and you'll see that some libraries even have a large print copy of it. So maybe you would rather have that. So you could place that one on hold. Super easy. So the other thing, going back to Novelist, that you might be interested in is the award winners and award-winning audiobooks. They feature audiobooks. So for those of you who are really into audiobooks, you know there are certain readers that are really great, and a bad reader can kill an audiobook. So you can even search your audiobooks by the narrator. So if you see over here on the side, Mike Lentz is the narrator here. So you can search by narrator if you find some that you really, really like. So I hope that you enjoy Novelist Plus. It makes it so easy to look for readers that you might like based on things that you've read and really enjoyed. And if you have any questions, please just give us a call at the library. We are very happy to help. Happy hunting!